And the Bible said he took all of his stuff and he went and joined himself to another country and he became a citizen of that country. The Bible said if he got so low, he was down in the hog pen. Oh my God. But the scripture said he came to himself. Oh, but what I like about it is he had a self to come to. If you put God in him, when they mess up, they'll come to themselves. Not that I'm giving our kids a license to go out there and mess up. No, I wish that you won't mess up. I wish that you don't go down the wrong path. And there were some things our kids are going to have to learn on their own. I wish I had some people in here. I know you ain't going to like this preacher. And you think that your kids going to be perfect. Amen, but they ain't perfect. None of our kids are here in perfect. You don't know what they're doing on that internet. You don't know who they're talking to. If the right song come on, amen, I've seen some of y'all church kids, amen, singing them worldly songs, amen. And I know you think they ain't singing it, but they singing it. And they got worldly friends. And my prayers is that the world don't rub off on them. Oh, I wish I had some people in here that know what I'm talking about. Because we live in a day and age where they're being challenged, and they're being tested, and they're being pressed. They're pressed to fit in. They're being pressed to be cool. They're trying to be sexy. But y'all ain't talking to me. See, we didn't have to deal with all that stuff. 20 years ago, the demon is not as bad as the demon is today.
And tell your neighbors, I know you want to turn it up, young people, but don't turn it up. Please, whatever you do, don't turn it up. I know you want a boy that ain't in the church. Please, don't get yourself a boy that ain't in the church. Get yourself a boy, amen, that's in the church. Get yourself somebody, amen, that's saved. I know he look good. I know, amen, you can't help yourself. I know. Amen. He cute, but he ain't ready to be nobody daddy. Wish I had somebody in here. You ain't ready to go down that road, amen, to mess your life up. And it's true. Oh, I know God, I know no amens in here today. But the Bible said, fathers, he said, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them up in the nurture, in the admonition of the Lord. Why would Paul say that? Because some of y'all are some angry parents. You're angry. You gotta love them. You know they're trying to find their way. Let them find their way. Just keep putting God in them. And I declare, if you put the love of God in them, and if you exemplify the love of God, they will find their way.
Glory, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
I don't try to shun my kids from the world, but I educate them about the world. I tell them about the consequences, amen, of having sex before you get married. I tell them about getting somebody pregnant. I tell them about the decisions that you make that can mess you up for life. I tell them about everything so when they, amen, are confronted with it, they will be informed. I tell them that one night could cost you 20 years of pain. I tell them that one night can give you something, amen, that the health department can't get rid of. I tell them, you need to share with them your mistakes. Stop trying to correct them and share with them the mistakes that you made, amen, amen, so that they won't have to make the same mistake. I wouldn't call everything a mistake, but share with them the experiences that you made, because how many know that experiences are the best teachers?
Yes, indeed.
The more you fuss, the worse are they going to get. Come on, say amen. The more you try to tie them around their neck, the worse are they going to get loose. Come on, say amen. See, because some of us grew up in households where we had a lot of discipline, and some of us grew up in households where we had no discipline. That's even worse, when you have no standard in the house. Ask your neighbor, say, what household did you grow up in? How many times your mama told you not to do something and you did it? How many times your father told you not to do something and you did it? How many times you test the water? You did everything that you wasn't supposed to do. And now when your kids make one mistake, you want to kill them. Come on, say amen. If they can't come to us and get no restoration, then where can they go? I don't know if it'll help me here. I'm not shocked today. So encourages us to have patience with our children. And bring them up in the nurture and the admonition of the Lord. Because if you don't have patience with them, you're going to lose them. So I'm talking about young people on the fence right now. They're in that age now. They're in that 18. They're in that teenage age now. They're in that age where they could go either way. I know you want to not deal with it, but they're in that age where what's outside is looking better than what's on the inside. Come on, say amen. Yeah. They're that age. Come on, say amen. You ain't going to talk to me, but it's reality. We're dealing with reality. We're not dealing with the housewives of Atlanta. Come on, say amen. These teenagers here got real challenges. And they got real issues. And the best thing we can do for them is pray for them right now. We got to pray for our kids. Come on, as much as you tell them to talk to that boy, they're going to talk to them. Come on, say amen. And tell God really did in their life. Until they go through some things where they're gonna have some hurts in life. They're gonna have some pain. And as much as we want to shun them from the pain that they gotta go through, they're gonna have to go through some things in order to believe this thing is real. That's reality. Some of us did some things, amen, that we know we shouldn't have did. Come on, say some of us ain't never did nothing. That's cool. Amen. But our kids are dealing with different things now.
Yes.
Amen. And I recognize that. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
I recognize that. I recognize that the kids are being challenged. And I pray for them. Come on, say. I talk to them. I'm always talking to them about real things that they're faced with. Don't act like it ain't happening and ain't nobody talking to them, because somebody is talking to them other than you. But you got to continue to share with them the word of God. You got to continue to, the Bible says, to bring them up. The word bring up means to build up, to bring them to church. Come on. You got to bring them to church so that when they get of age of understanding, they want to come on their own. Come on, say amen. Because time will tell. When they get out of your house, it's going to tell whether or not they really have God in them. The true test of really raising up kids is when they get out on their own, whether they continue in that what you have taught them. That's the challenge. Anybody can go to church under a forced situation. You just threaten them. You don't go to church, you got to get out of here. Come on, say amen. Yeah, from your mouth, we're going to serve the Lord. And the day you don't want to do that, the day you can go out and have your own life. But you got to have a standard. Come on, say amen. Wish I had some folk in here to know just what I'm talking about. Glory to God. So, amen. To bring them up means to instruct them in the knowledge of divine things. Glory to God. Amen. Set godly examples in front of them. You know the best thing you can do is be what you want your kids to be.
Amen. That's it.
Come on, say amen.
Yes, Lord.
You can't be something else and expect them to be godly and you're not godly. You can't be, saying godly things and then you home cussing people out. No. You can't be cussing people out, amen, and then in church act like you're lifting up the name of Jesus. But you got to be that example. You can't be fighting in front of your kids. Come on, let's see all that. Husbands, you got to learn how to treat your wife with love. And wives, you got to learn how to respect your husbands at all times. That's what the book said. This is the book. I don't know what book y'all read. It said, wives, Submit yourself unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, Christ is the head of the church, and therefore the Savior of the body. Then he says, husbands, love your wives. Don't get to shouting. Because some of y'all make those selfish. You don't love nobody but yourself up in here. And I believe if you love your wife, you'll get the respect. I believe if you respect your husband, you'll get the love. Come on, say amen. If he never tells the wife to love the husband. It tells the wife to respect the husband. Other words, a lot of women don't understand that because you want to be married and single all at the same time. Come on, say amen. I know you work, I know you do all of that. I know you got your own job, got your own car, got your own bank account. I know all of that. That ain't what the Bible says. You gotta go by what the book says. Many of us are so far from the book, that's why we can't get no peace. And if we don't operate by the book, we're going to have trouble. God don't want you operating by your feelings. He wants you to operate by the book. All that emotionalism, God don't care enough about that. God want to know, can you live by this word?
Come on now.
Some of us don't get in the book. That's why we don't know the book. That's why we talk stuff we don't know about. Because the only time we pick the book up is when we're in church. But we don't have a real divine relationship and a divine relationship with God. Amen. Come on, say amen. See, most of your images that these people getting and our kids are getting are from TV, and they're not biblical. They're not biblical because they're from TV. Most of the people they want to be like is somebody they seen on TV or somebody from the neighborhood. Somebody like what they call LM that came from nothing. Yeah, you get it. You hear him? That's it. He came from nothing. Come on, say amen. Glory to God. See, when I talk to young people, I want to talk real talk to them. About, well, let me talk about what's going on with you. What you're struggling with. What you can't tell your parents. Come on, say amen. They need an outlet. They need somebody they can talk to.
That's right.
Somebody they can trust. That's why youth leaders are so important in church.
Yes, yes.
Because the sister said, well, most people, Christians leave church and they go to college, they don't become Christians no more. They become sucked into the world. Because there's something on the other side of that grass that they're curious about.
Mm-hmm.
They're going over there wherever you want to know it or not.
That's true.
I hear somebody now, I repeat that, my child ain't going over there. And you're not going over. Some of y'all went over there, you didn't leave the church, but you went over there. So we got to set God examples in front of them. Be what you want your kids to be. That means having good, healthy relationships, good, healthy marriages. Our kids need good examples. Number three, all correction should be always done with love, not out of anger. It is our job as parents to pray for our kids and to bring them, amen, to the house of God. Amen? Amen. It's our job. It's our job not to exasperate or to provoke them to wrath. Come on, that's why we have so many kids, amen, fighting their parents. And there's no excuse for that. There's no excuse for you raising up, amen, getting in your mother's face or whatever. Glory to God. If you feel like you need to do that, you need to go outside somewhere.
That's right.
Amen. Because that will really provoke a real fight. Because we got some parents, amen, that ain't got it all together.
That's right.
Amen. If you raise up on them, it's going to be the end of that. They're gonna be like, girl, I'm killing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm searching. This is real talk. Because some of these kids, they will try you.
Yes,
they will push you to the limit.
Yes,
they will push you till you lose it.
Yes,
and then
when
you hit them, it will be over. See, when I was growing up, we didn't have Child Protective Service. Now they got Child Protective Service, DSS. They will hit you, you will hit them, and the people will come and knock you up. I know you bad. Try hitting one of these kids. All they got to do is put it on social media and it's going to go viral. And the police will be at your house and they will lock you up and take your kids. Some of y'all probably want to come and get them anyway. Come on, say amen.